begin my presentation by saying that everyone my friends and I ask thinks that the dress code is really unfair. We have a lot of rules that are hard to follow, and there are a lot of things that we can't wear, especially girls. The boys only have around one or two rules that they need to follow, which are gender neutral, and girls have at least four or five rules that are only directed towards them. Anyways, I hope you start to understand our dress code and also understand why the rules in it are extremely unfair and sexist. There are lots of pieces of clothing that I'm sure a lot of girls and teachers would love to wear. There are crop tops, backless shirts, tank tops, hats, and shorts, and we aren't allowed to wear any of those pieces. No one understands why we can't wear these articles of clothing, and the rules make no sense to anyone. They make a lot of people mad, especially the rule about how long our shorts need to be. Who can actually find shorts that fit the dress code, which basically makes us wear shorts that are down to our knees that are also even remotely cute? Also, I feel that students should be free to express themselves in what they wear. If that means wearing a crop top, the student should be able to do it. Teachers force a lot of rules on us that are really hard to follow, even rules that don't involve the dress code, but that's a completely different story. It's just not fair how we're so restricted with what we can and can't wear, and no one likes it at all. We can't wear shirts with open backs, shirts that show cleavage, shorts that go over fingertips, skirts that go over fingertips, or shirts that show our stomachs. That isn't fair to any of us at all. Anyways, all of these rules are especially unfair to girls with long torsos, long fingers, long arms, and long legs, and to girls who have more curves than others, and to girls who are on the taller side. Sometimes the dress code can be extremely stressful too. We have to focus so much on what we can and can't wear, instead of focusing on what we want to or should be doing, like homework, socializing, being outside, or studying, instead of focusing on our clothes. The rules in the dress code make us feel mistreated, and so that we have to think about what we wear at school way too often, and no one likes it at all. Some of us also become less confident in ourselves and our bodies because we aren't free in what we wear. We want to stop worrying about what we wear and start wearing what we actually feel good in. Some of us face depression, lack of confidence, negativity, and a lot of judgment because of what we have to wear and what we are forced to wear to school. My friend said that she worries about what she wears to school because she doesn't have a lot of options. Another said that she stresses about the shirt she wears because she likes crop tops and has a lot of them. For some of us, the only clothes we have that we actually like are clothes that we can't wear to school, like crop tops and spaghetti strap tank tops. As I said before, the rules in the dress code are very specific to girls. And like I said before, who can actually find shorts that fit the dress code that are even cute? No one understands why we can't wear these articles of clothing, and the rules make no sense to anyone.
Do you want to go to the next slide?
Sure.
Yep.
But we have to think about the teacher's point of view too. I'm sure they don't like it when we violate or go against a rule in the dress code. One teacher that I asked said that the students would get too distracted if we didn't have a dress code. Another said that the boys would probably get too distracted if the girls wore short shorts and crop tops all the time, which is probably true, but like I said before, that isn't our fault. Another teacher said, though, that she has trouble following the dress code when it gets hot out, and that she agrees with me that it's gender biased and sexist. So now, even some of the teachers are agreeing with me. If the dress code was more gender neutral, it would be fair to girls, and I wouldn't be talking to you about this topic right now. Because of our rules, a lot of girls feel like sexual objects at school. Our body shouldn't be sexualized at 12 and 13, or ever. Feeling good and confident in what I wear, no one should have a say in my appearance or my clothes. You honestly shouldn't be shocked if someone shows up to school wearing something inappropriate. What you really need to learn to do is learn how to speak with them respectfully if they violate a rule. If they show up wearing something inappropriate, ask them why they chose to wear that article of clothing. Once they actually explain it, tell them your concern about how it might offend other students and how it could impact them. If they're wearing an article of clothing that shows an image that has drugs or alcohol in it, share with them your concern that they could become a walking ad for drugs and alcohol. We are lucky, though, that we don't have a super strict dress code, but it's more on the moderate side. Though I disagree with most of the rules in our dress code, at least we don't have full school-issued uniforms like a lot of schools in the state do. After I've said all of this, I'm sure most, or at least some of you, understand why our dress code is unfair, how it's sexist, and how it's really gender biased. We can't control how our bodies are built, and we also can't control how other people's emotions based on how we're built physically, or if our bodies make you uncomfortable. So, now that this is over, I hope you understand our dress code and understand why it's sexist. Thank you for watching and listening to me talk about this, even if it didn't matter to you or was boring.